integrative health watch kaina nyingo current chariot embe tutabraini ke gusini yo corporate well-being ago in studio amiten aksharon nevalisha. Welcome to the show, Sharon.
Thank you, Karen.
Before we talk about corporate well-being and what it means, kindly tell us about yourself and what
okay. My name is Sharon Olago. I'm the founder of Lisha Living, which is a healthcare company that uses technology to just improve the overall health and well-being of individuals. So what we do is that we make sure we work with patients, but apart from patients, we also work with corporates in terms of making sure that people who are working are actually just healthy, happy, and productive, and feeling good, being able to employ themselves the best way they can. Yes.
One of the services you offer is corporate well-being programs. Mm-hmm. What does that entail?
Okay, so to explain corporate well-being programs, I may have to start by explaining corporate health. Mm-hmm. So corporate health is basically looking at the overall health of a workforce. And when I say a workforce, I'm talking whether it's 10 people or 20 people or 50 people, the people who are working mm-hmm. in Yogni. Mm-hmm. And so corporate well-being is making sure that these people are in a state to actually employ themselves the best way they can, to be productive, mm-hmm. To be innovative, to be creative. All of these things actually depend on health, mm-hmm. and we forget about that. So there are two aspects to this. There's the physical health of the company, okay. but there's also the individual's health. Mm-hmm. Because when the person comes into the company, they cannot leave their problems and troubles at the door. Mm-hmm. Because they have to come in with the same brain True. And the same mind. So when they come into the company, mm-hmm. they sit there. The question is this person in the right state to be as productive as they possibly can? Will they be creative? Will they be innovative? Will they actually deliver on what the company expects them to deliver? Mm-hmm. So corporate well-being is making sure that this person is ready. This person is ready mm-hmm. to be the best they can be in actually delivering this mm-hmm. things.
Yes. I'm imagining this person should have the right mindset mm-hmm. in order to produce well. Mm-hmm. You mentioned two states.
Yes.
The well-being of the company and that of the individual.
Yes.
What's the linkage? Why should a company consider the well-being of its employees?
Yes, okay. So the well-being of the individual starts, let's just start with basic things, mm-hmm. physical health. Mm-hmm. If you come to the company, to the office, and you, number one, you've not been sleeping. You've been having insomnia, meaning that probably you've been sleeping 4 hours mm-hmm. in a night. Number two, because you've been sleeping 4 hours in a night, you're a bit cranky, you're tired, you cannot actually produce as you should be producing, mm-hmm. but you'll come because you have to be at the office. What it means is that once you're seated there, the amount of work and the amount of the output that you will be giving is not what the company expects you to actually deliver, because you cannot function, your brain cannot function optimally without right sleep. As simple as that. So here we are looking at the individual's ill health, because maybe they are not sick, mm-hmm. but they are definitely of ill health.
Yes.
Yeah, the individual's ill health is completely affecting the corporate's well, mm-hmm. because number one, if you're not delivering on your work, you're also affecting other people's work in that company. But you're mm-hmm. also affecting the other thing, the profitability, the productivity of the whole company. Mm-hmm. So these two, we can look at the individual and the corporate as separate, but they're so interlinked. Mm-hmm. And that is why when we look at a company, we need to consider this company within the context of the individuals who are working in it and how well they can actually produce and they can actually employ themselves into the work they are doing. Mm-hmm. Yes.
Does that mean when you you're in a partnership with a company, mm-hmm. you interview, you evaluate every employee of that company?
Yes.
Okay.
It has to start with that. Mm-hmm. We audit two things. First, we audit the company. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes some companies can be toxic, you understand? Mm-hmm. And when I say toxic, people may not think the company is toxic, but there are things that could be happening in the company that actually are not contributing positively.
And what could those things be?
Let's
just
start
examples.
With food.
Mm-hmm.
Let's start with food, because we take these things lightly. Mm-hmm. But there are very many companies with good intention, like the best intention. Mm-hmm. So they'll make sure that in the morning breakfast, all the imagine is there, lunch, all the food you can imagine is there. But the way people are eating is actually leading to obesity, to type 2 diabetes, to, you know, illnesses that are necessary. So lifestyle. As much as you're cooking, and you know, they think, most people think that ukeka nyama nyingi. Ukeka nyama nyingi ndio watu wamefurahia, sasa you're treating people well.
But you know, Kenyans love meat.
We love meat, but we love health more. True. And we love life. So we look basic things in the environment, like what is the nutrition in that company? How do people relate? How do people relate is very important in terms of communication. Because communication can either empower you as someone who's working in a company, or it can actually disempower you to a point of being powerless, where you find yourself, you know the answer, but to say me, you see? Because that behavior of, you know the answer, you know how to solve it, like, lakini umenyamaza. When people act like that, there's something that is there. But there are simple tests that can be run in a company, very simple tests. And these are tests where we just send questionnaires. We send questionnaires, people answer. But through the answers, you can know, is this a company that is actually taking care of the physical? Is it taking care of the mental health of this person? And then now with the individual, what we do is simple assessments, because we need to do, we start by having a proper nutrition assessment, where we set up a camp in the company, and we set up a camp where the nutritionist coming in, and we do basic BMI, we do the waist circumference, and the hip circumference. Because you will be shocked, but waist, this there's so much research that has been done on unajua this fat that collects here on the waist.
Abdomen,
yes, this fat that collects can indicate very many things, that, and it also indicates diseases. But it also has been linked to higher cortisol level. You know, cortisol is that stress hormone. So we carry out a simple test like that, and then after we've done the nutrition test, we start to look at, okay, what is the actual physical health of this person? And you'll be surprised, the number of people we've got who have diabetes now are Jewy.
Wow.
Pre-diabetes. Yes. There are times that we've had to actually send people to hospital because of the level of their blood pressure. Like, it is so extreme that you're wondering how this person is working and walking in the office. So people are walking and working and doing things when they are so ill.
And they don't know.
And they don't know because they are so accustomed to bad health. So I think as companies, we have to get to this level, we have to get to this level where we actually invest also in the physical health of this individual. Because most of these things are treated very well by just changing your habits and changing your behavior in terms of what you eat, how you move, your sleep, how you manage this negative thoughts that heads. And these things are not obvious. People need to be helped to actually work towards there, because we have so many other problems, you know, school fees ndio hiyo, sijui mambo ya hospitali ya mtu mwingine na wewe ndio mgonjwa unalipa pia.
We have COVID right now.
We are working from home. So companies need to think about investing more, so they can help people move forward a bit, because times are hard, and people are also just not physically healthy right now. Not at all. Yes.
So you've mentioned physical health.
Yes.
What are the other types of corporate well-being that companies should look out for?
Okay, apart from physical health, there's mental health. And you'll be surprised, but mental ill health in a company comes a lot from simple things like communication, gratitude. When I'm sitting here with you and everything you say is toxic to me,
it will affect you.
Especially if you're my boss. You see, if you're my colleague, naweza kuja pia wewe nikupatie toxic. Tupumanishane kidogo, you understand?
But it's hard if it's coming from the management.
If it's your management who is constantly stepping on your head, constantly, constantly, and there are bosses like that. So The thing with this kind of behavior is that people spend up to 60% of their waking hours at work. Mm-hmm. 60%. Mm. So surely this person, you're being insulting to them, you are not acknowledging the work they should be doing, you're even taking roles that they should be actually doing themselves by treating them like a fool.
Yeah.
Over time, this person begins to now let go. But you see, when you let go and you say, hey, wacha tu basi atafanya, wacha tu atafanya, it's actually affecting you then much more than the other people.
Mm-hmm.
So we work with people to firstly just educate the whole company. We bring them all together into a room to start by simple things about firstly hormones. How do the hormones in your brain work?
Mm-hmm.
You know? What is this thing we hear about stress hormones?
Yeah.
Huh? Why is it bad when your stress hormones are completely high the whole time? Your adrenaline, when you come a mtu, unafukuzwa na lion. You can imagine that.
Yes.
Constantly, you're having palpitations and all that.
You're anxious.
You're anxious. Mm-hmm. It's because of how you're relating to others. So, and these things, one talk is not enough. That's why you see, I think, you know, we run 12-week programs.
Mm-hmm.
And we do it, we run the 12-week programs because it has to be nurtured in. Habit is not something that is just uprooted.
True.
We have to nurture it in so that we make sure that in terms of the mental well-being, this person feels valued.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
And being valued, sio kubembelezwa kabisa. When there's time for a tough hand, and you will give the tough hand. But on the other hand, when someone is doing good, just say thank you, you know? You've done great. This is better than yesterday.
Mm-hmm.
Simple words.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm. So this is now the mental aspect of it.
Okay.
Other aspects of it are spiritual. And we take it for granted, but we are spiritual people.
Mm-hmm.
We are. And especially as Kenyans, we're actually spiritual human beings.
Mm.
So things, values like gratitude really help, you know?
Okay.
And being able to just value the spirit in someone else, laughing.
Mm-hmm.
Because all those things are spiritual things, you know?
Yeah.
Thanksgiving. And being able to acknowledge people when they do something.
Mm-hmm.
That's very important.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
But I think as Kenyans, we don't see the difference between spirituality and religion. There's that bloodline.
That's very true.
Mm-hmm.
There's a very blood line because when you say spiritual, people may think I may be saying sisi wote because they're different cultures.
Mm-hmm.
There are companies where people pray together, and that's fine.
Yeah.
Because prayer, actually, even this is now based on science,
mm-hmm.
prayer has been found to have a very, very positive effect
mm-hmm.
on the mental health, you
mm-hmm.
know? But we are not saying being religious,
mm-hmm.
but prayer does help.
True.
And it's not only prayer, sometimes it's taking a walk outside and sitting down and breathing.
Mm-hmm.
Breathing.
Because being in touch with your higher self.
Yes, mm-hmm. because it changes. It's meditation.
Mm-hmm.
For some people, they meditate with a phrase, you know, simple words like, you know, today will be a good day. Thank you. Today will be a good day. The affirmations.
Mm-hmm.
And these affirmations help because as human beings, our brains tend to go for the negative before they go for the positive. And sometimes you take one negative and the next thing you know, you're going so negative until everyone around you is just out to kill you. And it is not true. Uliona tu mtu akikuangalia vibaya hivi. And that person was constipated. Hakuwa anakuangalia vibaya.
They're dealing with their own struggles.
They're dealing with their own struggles in their stomach. But sasa wewe ushaona vile, hey, Karen is out for me,
mm-hmm.
out for me. And you've gone to a point where in your head, this person has already killed you, they came for you at night.
Mm-hmm.
You know, craziness.
Yeah.
And that's how, and the brain works like that. It was good at a certain time when we were living in caves. It was very good because it made
survival.
Sure, you know, we could survive. But in this day and age where you're sitting on your desk,
mm-hmm.
it's still there, but we have to find a way of taming it.
Mm-hmm.
And this is where now the spiritual aspect comes in.
Okay.
Because it tames those
thoughts.
Automatic mm-hmm. negative thoughts that keep on coming.
Yeah.
And so we meditate, we pray, we call someone we love and we say, how is your day? I'm actually having a bad day.
Mm.
But this person who's in the office, should be allowed to actually just have that little time, because it's 15 minutes at a, during lunchtime,
mm-hmm.
where they can go outside and just recalibrate and bring themselves back into a higher level.
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Okay. Any other type?
Any other type of work?
The corporate well-being.
Teamwork.
Physical.
Teamwork. Uh-huh. Teamwork. Because there's physical, but there's also teamwork, mm-hmm. and the benefits of teamwork and how teamwork should actually work.
Mm-hmm.
Because you see, all these things we've spoken about the full, we've spoken
spiritual.
About the spiritual, mm-hmm. we've spoken
mental.
About the mental, but teamwork is now the social aspect, isn't
okay.
it?
Mm-hmm.
Because we are social beings, and it connects to all of this. Because when the three are doing well,
mm-hmm.
the social aspect works well.
But you find that as humans, yes. we're all different.
Yes.
How do you bring in all these people together to work as a team?
Wow. Now, that is a good question for a HR specialist. We have a big team of medical microbiologists and scientists,
yeah.
but what we are saying is that if you come to the team
mm-hmm.
when your mental well-being is okay,
mm-hmm.
when your physical health is okay, you know, spiritually, you're not expecting the next person to kill you. It means your ability to begin with, just to
mm-hmm.
listen, your ability to listen is much better, because teamwork at the end of the day is you're looking at how two people or more can work together. And how do people work together? By communicating.
Mm-hmm.
So if every aspect of this human, of the individual, is in the right place to work together, because there's delegation. Simple things like delegation. If we are working in a team and you say, okay, Sharon is in charge of this, Sharon
mm-hmm.
will go and buy the flowers.
Mm-hmm. Hmm?
But every minute, the moment I've come out, I've just left the room. Huh? We've already
it's
agreed
toxic.
The flowers, but what
mm.
store are you buying them from?
Yeah.
How are you going to how are you going to do this?
Mm-hmm.
You see how that actually brings some kind of
friction mm-hmm.
you know, in how we relate. But the truth of the matter is that this person who is also rushing you like that, ako na mambo yake hapo, there's
mm-hmm.
a bit of ill health.
Mm-hmm.
And whether we want to accept it or not, there's a bit of ill health. So we need to learn how to, number one, deal with people like this. Because we cannot run away from them. They're in every company. And managers
mm-hmm.
need to know where to put them, because
mm-hmm.
also their departments, you would put them and your profitability will dip completely
yeah.
down.
Mm-hmm.
So we need to learn how to respond to people like this.
Mm-hmm.
But we also need to learn how to work as a team. So this person can be tamed a bit down.
Mm-hmm.
Just by phrases, you know, when you're inquiring about this. You need to do it in a productive way. So giving people empowering words
mm-hmm.
rather than disempowering words.
Okay.
Yes.
With all that you've said, in Kenya, we really look at all that. If a company looks at the well-being of the employee, often it's the physical.
Mm-hmm.
They leave out the rest.
Mm-hmm.
Why is that? And to add to that, traditionally,
mm-hmm.
companies, once they've issued out medical covers, that's it for them. They wash their hands.
Mm.
There's no encouragement for these employees to actually have a good well-being.
Mm.
So how do you as a company come in and encourage this? Look at all these other attributes of the well-being of the employee, firstly. Secondly, to look at how best they can make their environment
yes.
better for these employees.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Firstly, I really believe that companies are willing to do this.
Mm-hmm.
The biggest challenge is how companies think that by buying medical coverage
mm-hmm.
for their employees, what you're buying as a company, if you buy medical coverage, is you're just buying that security of if they get ill,
mm-hmm.
and ill, if they get ill, they can
mm-hmm.
go to hospital.
Mm-hmm.
But the problem is, in Kenya, as Kenyans, we have a very, very low standard of good health. Very low standard.
Mm-hmm.
And it is not the sickness that is in hospital that causes the low productivity and the losses in the company. No. It is this every day going to the office while you are of ill health and taking for granted, you know?
Mm-hmm.
It is our habits. Not sleeping well, drinking every evening.
Mm-hmm.
Let's be honest, huh? Yeah, we are a true drinking culture.
A true drinking
mm-hmm.
culture.
Drinking every evening, and you'll say, oh, I'm not in the office, but the effect will be seen in that office. You can't just
say,
oh,
I'm very, there are people who say, no, you should see me, I'm drunk. Mm-hmm. I'm very productive. I'm doing wonderful.
Mm.
You know, apart from that, lack of movement, physical inactivity just literally kills everything in your body.
Mm-hmm.
From your brain to your metabolism, your brain performance is lower. Your metabolism is made so much, it's so much slower than it should be, which means
mm-hmm.
that the energy you give out is also much less in terms of your brain power and your physical activity.
Mm-hmm.
And insurance companies will not help you with this.
True.
Because you have to remember, then they're looking at reducing the mm-hmm. cost, mm-hmm. isn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah, because they also don't want you to claim too much. So I think the role of insurance companies is great
mm-hmm.
and very needed
mm-hmm.
because you're looking at, in case of a risk, mm-hmm. they're covered. But on the other hand,
mm-hmm.
what we want to do is to make sure us companies
mm-hmm.
can also just take the responsibility and be more accountable
mm-hmm.
for their employees' well-being.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Before we continue to how this will translate to being an important
yes.
Aspect of a company's productivity, I would like us to take a short break.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.